will not keep you waiting a moment.
I hope not. I'm catching the train back to Bombay this evening.
I'll inform her of your wish.
Well, it's not so much my wish as my intention.
You must remember, sir, Lady Eppingham is getting on in years.
Proceed.
Yes, well, the will is quite straightforward. This tea estate is left to a sole surviving relative, Lady Eppingham.
Well, that's the least she could do.
Well, what else?
Well, nothing.
But he must have been worth a fortune. Who the hell gets that?
Well, his estate in Norfolk will be created in the National Trust.
What?
Presumably to cut down the death duties, which still amounted to £250,000.
Good God!
You mean the British government gets $250,000, the National Trust gets half of Norfolk, and Auntie gets nothing but this place?
Well, the income from this estate is quite considerable. Let me see, in 1960 it was £20,000.
Yeah, well, it's nothing like that now, I can tell you.
So I gather it's halved in the last 10 years.
That's because Lord Rothbury wouldn't plough back any of his damn profits into modernising the place. Quite.
So it's a considerable drop in such a short period.
Oh, what is it? Sir, Linton says you will not keep you home. Can I dealt with it?
Yes, sir, don't disturb on my account.
Tell the flight, boy. Tell the danger. But I'm trying to sober up my husband. You're not to drink before the ball. Why don't you keep an eye on my husband?
Yes, ma'am, sir.
Harry, you're not even dressed yet.
I'm Lando, Lady Eppingham, Father Lando.
Don't be silly. There's the ample opportunity to dance at the ball.
I beg your pardon.
Oh, you should see me dance the polka. La 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 la.
Come and sit down.
Oh, don't be such a bully, Martin. Would you get me a brandy, Jeremy?
Now you know what the doctor said.
Oh, fiddlesticks. Make it a large brandy.
Lady Eppingham.
The doctor.
We tried to explain. You wouldn't wish to see him.
No, I hate doctors. Always have.
I'm not a doctor.
Oh, the fact I can seem to stop you from practicing, does it?
I'm a solicitor.
But of course you are. I've been waiting for you, haven't I?
Oh, have you? Oh, not a relief.
I think I should get away with manslaughter, don't you?
Oh, Lester.
Well, nobody deserves it more than Harry.
Your husband?
I caught him philandering with one of the native girls. I had to shoot him, didn't I?
Shoot? Oh, yes. Of course.
Miss, I will not be distressing yourself. This solicitor is Mr. Basil Lander.
Oh, well, he found his fault at some length. Right.
I'm from Bombay.
Oh, are you?
Yes, Mr. Landau is with the firm in Bombay.
Is he?
Here's your brandy, Auntie.
Oh, thank you. Oh, I shall miss these two when they go back to school. Well, good health to everyone. And a long life to you, Harry, my darling.
Oh, cheers.
Now then, you were saying, Mr. Landau.
As I was saying, Aunt, he's called to see you on important business.
Yes. Cooper, and me.
No, Mr. Lander has nothing to do with them.
I don't blame him. They're a load of scoundrels.
Lady Eppingham, if I could just briefly reiterate.
By all means, Jeremy, show the gentleman where.
Shall I talk well, Mr. Lander? Oh, I think not.
Well, go on. Now I saw you be waiting for us.
Lady Eppingham, if I could have your undivided attention.
Did I say something funny, Jeremy?
No, Mr. Landau did.
Mr. Landau? Who's that?
Well, I am Mr. Landau.
Oh, well, don't keep introducing yourself. It's a very irritating habit.
Look, the London firm of Cooper, Cooper and Hillam instructed me to call on you personally and owing to the distressing nature of their news.
How very thoughtful of them. Has something happened to the tea shares?
No.
Oh, they've been going down steadily for years, you know.
Yes, so I gather, but that's not what I called about.
Well, it's very kind of you to come. Goodbye.
But no, there's something else.
Yes, I'm afraid you concerned your father.
My father? Good God, that fellow's not still alive, is he?
I regret to have to inform you that last week Lord Rothbury, aged 98, met an untimely end.
Hardly untimely at 98.
Well, care to know the details, Lady Eppingham?
I think this dress has faded, don't you?
I beg your pardon?
Tell me, would you say that this was gold?
Well, yes, I suppose.
the only one, the apple of his eye and all that. Oh, he took me to my coming out ball last week. That's where I met Harry. Do you know, the impetuous young man wants to marry me and take me out to India. Well, had my father had a tea estate out there, I very well might do it.
I get you, Grundy, auntie.
And I change my mind, if I may.
Well, you were saying, Mr. Landau.
I beg your pardon?
About my father, not Rothbury.
What's that?
Died. No. Faded.
How did it happen?
I told you. The son.
Well, I'm sure Lady Eppingham would be happy to know that the father died in harness.
Good heavens. How did he come to do that?
Well, during a debate in the House of Lords, he was found to be dead.
How could they tell?
Here's your grandy, auntie.
Oh, thank you.
Linda, it is heart.
Yes, it would be.
The point is, as I've already explained to your nephews.
Oh, they're not my nephews. They're Harry's brother's boys. We have no children of our own, you see, so I have to take them in. Do you know Harry's brother?
No.
You don't know much, do you? Would you ring that bell for me, Doctor?
Yes, sir.
I want to ask you if he's walked in the Viceroy's entrance.
I was saying that under the terms of the will, you are to inherit his tea estate.
Harry will be pleased.
Yes, I'm sure he will. His estate in Norfolk, he bequeathed to the National Trust.
Everything else had to be sold to pay death duties.
Death duties? Somebody died?
Father, Lord Rothbury.
Where?
He's died. Mr. Landau's come all the way from Bombay to tell you that you've inherited his estate, and Marty and I have got sweet Fanny Adams.
Really? Will you bring that again, please? How much exactly went in debt duties, Mr. Landau?
Something in the region of £250,000.
Oh, good heavens, that's iniquitous.
Don't upset yourself, Auntie. At least you've got this place. Marty and I got nothing.
Really? What about that sweet items girl? Oh, let her in, will you?
Coming! You rang me, sir.
I don't think so. Did I?
No, get out. Well, I thought I am getting bills. Clear.
Don't be such a bully, Martin. If you're more heavy yells bell, then you should treat you gently. Come and tell us all about it, Ramon.
I rang the bell, you get him.
Whatever for?
Well, it's something
to do with the elephant. Elephant? What elephant?
Well, the Viceroy's.
Mr. Landau, you're wondering. Why, there hadn't been a Viceroy in India for years.
Oh, all right, Ramon, get out. Very good, sir.
Would you tell the driver of my taxi? I wouldn't be very long, you know.
Taxi?
Yes, it's outside.
We don't need a taxi, Harry. We're going to the ball of the Viceroy's elephant. That's all, Ramon.
Very good, then, sir.
Lady Eppingham, I have to be at the station.
Ah, now when you get formal with me, I know you're cross with me.
Have you anything else to tell us, Mr. Landau?
I don't think so. Cooper Copen Hill will be forwarded a photocopy of the will. When we have had a perusal of it, we'll send it on to you.
I shouldn't bother. I should protest.
Contest?
Yes. How do one do about that, Mr. Landau?
Well, basically, there are only two grounds to take such a course of action.
And they are?
But firstly, if it can be shown that at the time the will was drawn up, Lord Rothbury was not a compass member.
Oh, he was always that.
There was absolutely nothing to show that your father was anything but normal.
Ah, what about wearing a harness in the House of Lords?
What's the same requirement for contesting?
If you suffered financial hardship by being mistreated in the will.
That's the one. We'll go for that one.
Your case will be very slim.
Why?
Well, you've inherited this estate. What?
My good man, we can't live off this. Why, the crop is appalling. We must be the only tea growers in India who have to drink instant coffee.
Well, it wouldn't just be the annual income which would affect the issue.
There's nothing else, is there?
Certainly, the Attorney General would have to take into account the capital value of the place.
I told you, there is no value.
I'm sure if you choose to sell, you would realise lucky to the Attorney General.
You can tell the Attorney General that he will evict me only over my dead body. Who the hell does he think he is?
We are dealing with a hypothesis, Lady Eppingham.
And a very dangerous one. You can tell him that if he sets one foot in Jalapur, or if he tries to molest me in any way, I shall arm the natives. What was I saying?
You're explaining a precarious financial situation, Auntie.
Ah, yes. Martin, what was the turnover for last year?
Well, I don't know.
But of course you do. You keep the books, don't you?
Yes.
Well, if you spent more time looking after your work instead of philandering with those native girls, and if you kept your face out of a whiskey glass for 5 minutes, we'd be much better off. Sponger, the both of them. Women and drink. Takes that to Sir Harry, of course. Only he did both at the same time. I rather admired him for it.
I think this place is run damn well.
Rubbish!
Do you think we should contest the rooms, Alanda?
Well, that's really up to Lady Eppingham.
Oh, I'm up to it, all right.
Well, fortunately, we don't have to decide on it tonight. Now, what about your train, Landau?
We could decide tonight.
Leave it.
Yes, I really must be going there. Here's my card, Lady Eppingham.
Oh! I'll mark the last waltz down for you.
But I'm leaving now.
Well, I'll see you out. Cheerio, Landau.
You can't.
I must.
No.
Yes, Mr. Landau has to go on.
Oh, well, if he has to, see him out then. Harry and I are going to walk to the North. Come.
Yes, this really must be free.
Yes. Oh, good heavens. It's snowing again.
Crazy old fool. £100,000, eh?
Looks like we just have to wait until she kicks the bucket.
Yes.
Good job Caroline's on the way, isn't it?
What do you know about Caroline?
Only that your tongue just got to say to that. Why are you calling again? I thought last time you wouldn't take her away.
Last time I couldn't afford it.
Oh. So you dropped his price?
No.
I see. So that's why you stepped up at Fiddley.
What do you mean?
Oh, I don't mind. As long as you keep those cellar well stocked. But you want to be careful. If Artie find out, she might change your will. She knew you were selling half a tea on the side.
Where the hell did you get that information from?
Oh, little brother's watching you.
Yes, and I don't like it.
No, I don't like it either. I don't like being kept in the dark. We're supposed to do this thing together. I might have to make my own arrangements.
What are you talking about?
Well, Auntie's departure. You spend too much time and money on that, on those women of yours. I suppose she's still got that expensive girl in Janet for.
No.
Found one for the one in Calcutta, did she?
Excuse me, sir. Oh, what is it?
Two ladies have arrived.
Two ladies?
And a double booking.
They are hoping to find Landau, sir.
Landau?
Well, better show them in, I suppose.
Good evening. I hope I'm in time to catch Mr. Landau.
Only just, I'm afraid he's about to leave the party back to Bombay. Removed. Couldn't find him. He's with his relationship on the lawn somewhere.
I must apologise for my
terrible visit. Don't apologise, I'm delighted.
I'm sorry,
Mr. Martin Eppingham.
I'm Mr. Eppingham.
Oh, my brother Jeremy.
I'm very pleased to make your acquaintance.
Yes, me too.
I'm a business colleague of Mr. Landau's.
Not the same firm, surely?
Yes, but of course, I'm only a junior partner.
You're not a solicitor, are you?
Yes, why not?
Well, aren't you attractive?
Does that mean you would not avail yourself of my services?
On the contrary, can I get you a drink, Mr.
Yes, thank you.
Whiskey, brandy, sherry?
A glass of sherry, please.
Won't you sit down, Mr. Finney? There we are. Medium dry, how's that?
Yes, thank you.
Ramon said something about two ladies.
Ah, yes, Mrs. Horrocks.
Mrs. Horrocks?
I asked her to wait in the taxi outside. I want to see Mr. Landau before asking her in. If this is my gentleman, I'll tell her it used to be green and it's shrunk.
But she's Landau's partner.
Well, for the last waltz.
Miss Lookagers, with my prayer, Lady Eppingham.
All right, all right.
But I was merely reiterating.
Well, don't. It's a very unpleasant habit of yours. Well, go on.
Miss
Introduce us, you fool.
Lady Eppingham.
Both of us.
Please, Miss Up, who is this gentleman?
Oh, I'm sorry. You never understand protocol, Harry. I'm very sorry, Harry.
Sir Harry and Lady Eppingham.
secret here.
How do you do, Lady Eppingham?
I think you should try some calamine lotion. Give her a prescription, Doctor.
Doctor?
Oh, one moment, please. Mr. Pitcher, what on earth brings you out here?
Your clock got repaired, did I hit you before you left?
Why, for heaven's sake?
The unexpected arrival of Mrs. Horrocks.
Mrs. Joinover, lady.
You're not to whisper, Doctor. If there's anything radically wrong with me, I have a right to know.
They're talking business, Auntie.
Well, they're not to do it in my house. Haven't you got an office in Mr. Landau?
Indeed I have. Would that I were there now instead of in here.
Careful now.
Mr. Pitcher, I will be leaving you within the next few minutes to catch the 8:17 train back to Bombay by way of Patna. I suggest you accompany me as you know the journey. You can tell me whatever it is you have to tell me about this Mrs.
Horrocks. Horrocks.
Precisely.
Mr. Landau, I'm afraid that until this matter is cleared, that neither of us can leave.
Ah, splendid. Martin, go and tell the room to air the double bed in the blue room.
Why do you do your own damn pelican and have done with it? Rabble!
And if you must shout, do it quietly, Martin.
What about this Mrs. Horrocks who's waiting outside?
Well, I'll tell her it was green and what's more, it struck.
You called so?
He shouted the room.
Another lady arrived with Mr. Pitcher.
Yes, sir.
Well, show her in.
Very good, sir.
Well, come on, then. What's this all about?
This letter will alter things very considerably.
In what way alter?
I told you. At least 2 inches on the head.
Lady Eppingham, would you allow me to...
But of course. You're my lawyer, aren't you? You must get my story straight.
Oh, yes. What story?
And how I murdered my husband. Tell them it was suicide or a shooting accident.
Yes, of course.
Well, come on now. I want to show you my geponica. It's absolutely beautiful at this time of the year. Oh, Martin! The locusts have denuded my fir tree again. Oh, no. It's all right, Martin. It's the flagpole.
I know. Mrs. Horrocks has filed the National Trust, and she's flown over here to take a piece of the estate as well.
To the best of my knowledge, Mrs. Horrocks is in no way connected to that organisation.
Well, just what is she concerned with it?
I'll leave Mr. Landau to explain both that and the Cosil.
Cosil? What Cosil?
To Lord Rothbury's will. Apparently, it was lodged with the bank, but was not discovered until 3 days after the will had been opened.
Mr. Pitcher, when did this letter arrive?
Yesterday, shortly after you left Bombay.
And you verified it?
We cabled to the Cooper and Till immediately. The reply is attached to the letter there.
Yes, I noted that. And the photocopy of the codicil.
Yesterday, Mrs. Horrocks flew in from London and we took the next available flight to Jaipur.
Is there any chance you're publishing this information?
Well, it appears that the codicil to Lord Rothbury's will has come into possession of Cooper, Cooper and Till. I have a photocopy here. And if the information is correct, this tea estate will have a new manager as from today.
What the hell are you talking about?
Lord Rothbury has stipulated that although this estate is bequeathed to Lady Eppingham, it is to be managed by Mrs. Beatrice Horrocks.
What?
And she is to live here as one of the family.
Well, what on earth should he drag in a complete stranger?
And Mrs. Horrocks is not a complete stranger.
She is to us.
But not to the Lady Lord Rothbury. She is in fact his daughter.
What? No, he hasn't got another daughter. Aunt Hester's the only one.
That's right. No brothers or sisters, nobody.
Mrs. Horrocks and Lord Rothbury is illegitimate daughter.
I'm sorry. I can't wait in that taxi any longer. Where's the little girl's room? Absolutely perfect. Only the aristocracy can put up with muck like this.
Oh, my thirsty.
You could grow radishes up here.
Mimsar!
You great daft fat!
What is Mimsar doing?
Branding his eyes, what does it look like?
What about the curtains?
Taking them down and giving them a good scrub. Looking if you've had them down for a while.
They have not been touched since 1952.
No, that's what it looks like.
But Mimsar should not be undertaking such menial tasks. We have housewives between this.
Not very well by the looks of it.
Lady Eppingham sees what you are doing, she will go mad.
It's late for that, I would have thought. Give us your hand. I'm coming down.
Mimsar is not permitted.
Oh, come on, for goodness sake. It's only me I'm offering you. Come on, order this. Now, that was all quite painless, wasn't it?
The men's office will notice that our customer's out here, but she will learn.
If there's any learning to be done, it'll be done by you lot.
Our way of life goes back many hundreds of years. We have strict rules to abide by. In my religion, I am taught humility, respect, and reverence.
Well, you can start the reverence in those. Take them out into the balcony and give them a good shake while I proceed back to the concern.
Yes, sir. Come on.
Aren't any of the family up yet?
Did you come in the morning?
What about my sister?
No, Lady Eppingham is sleeping in this morning. She and Sir Harry are dining in Government House.
Well, there is no Sir Harry.
There is no Government House either, but...
Bug is in the back, dear.
Mims up.
Get stuck in, bug it in.
But Mims up.
Don't tell me. Walk is against your religion as well.
But Mims up, I am not Toby Waller.
Dobie what?
Dobie laundry. We have special houseboy for doing this.
Like the one that does the dusting?
Yes, yes.
Get your sleeves rolled up. We've got a lot of work to be getting on with.
Lady Eppingham would never have to do such thing.
Mother, she's not the only pebble on the beach. As for the last lad, I'm the manageress now.
But what about Martin, sir?
Oh, don't worry about him. I'll find him plenty of work to do.
Yes, Ben, sir.
Oh, I say. Isn't it exciting? 2 days ago, out, in fact. Yesterday morning, Bombay, and now, here I am. Dobie Wallerin in Yankee Pool.
Janet Pool?
Ah, that's
it. It is a long way to travel.
It is, just to wash a pair of curtains.
Mims haven't travelled all this way to wash the curtains.
Don't you the joker, dear. You ever been to Halifax?
Halifax.
It's in West Yorkshire.
No.
It's in the north of England.
No, never.
Well, after this morning I've seen you down the Bradford Road. Say that. Our whole way of life has been changed. Even our very beans have been covered. Look at that. Look at the muck that's come out of there. That's only after one quick dip.
Men's up does look like Indian curry.
Yes, all right, I suppose.
It was on the menu last night.
Was it?
Yes, but men's up did not come down.
Oh, I thought it was best to see. After all that rumpus when I arrived, those two boys were in a rag state. And then your poor sister mistaken me for Lady Mountbatten. What made her like that? Was it the sun?
No, Mims only came like that after the accident.
What happened to her?
Nothing. It was Sir Harry. He was killed in a shooting accident.
Oh, poor sister.
No, no, she's not poor. She's a very great English lady.
Yes. It's hard to believe that she and me have the same dad.
Very hard to believe.
You've got any family trouble?
I had a sister, Mimsar, once.
Oh, I am sorry.
Mimsar is liking it here in India.
Oh, I should say. The East is much more erotic.
No, no, no! Where the hell are you?
Good morning.
What the hell are you doing?
Good morning, Martin. We're all be wallowing.
Never mind that. No one's had any breakfast yet.
I have. Up with a lark, that's me.
We don't have any larks out here, Mrs. Horrocks.
Well, you've got something that makes a jolly old rabbit.
Those are kitty dogs, Mimsar.
Well, I was up with them, then.
Remove. Have there been any phone calls this morning?
Phone calls?
Has anyone run up from the station?
No, sir. Are you wishing me to teleport?
No, no, just had the breakfast.
Very good, sir.
Bravo! It doesn't matter about this morning, as I arrived it was unexpected.
A bit!
But in the future, I like to kick off with cornflakes and kippers. Got that? Kippers.
Kippers.
Yeah, Martin, isn't he a scream? Look at these. I'll give you up a treat. Well, I'm going to start on the coochie covers next.
I don't think that would be necessary, Mrs. Horrocks.
Oh, I don't mind pulling your weight. And for goodness sake, don't call me Mrs. Horrocks. I'm Beatrice to my friends, but seeing as I'm related, you can call me Beauty.
As your holiday here is likely to be brief, I don't think that will become necessary. Hello, hello, it's the telephone station.
I'm not on holiday, Martin. I'm you, Keats. Manageress, that's me. But don't worry, I won't be making you redundant.
No, I don't give you the number. I think you'll find you're rather out of your depth here. It's not like England, you know.
Good job, too. What with the weather freezing you and the government squeezing you, it's getting worse than Siberia. It isn't a small man, you know. I was feeling a pinch in my haberdasher back in Kenya. There I've been selling Indian cottons for years. Never ever thought I'd find out where they came from. The main thing is, you see, I've got my family here.
That hasn't actually been established yet.
Do you know, up to 3 days ago, I didn't have a relative to my name after my George was taken. Apart from Lord Rothbury, that is. And I didn't know about him until after he snuffed it.
Hello? Yes, has the Calcutta train arrived yet? What do you mean delayed at Patna? How long a delay?
I was advertised for, you know, in the papers. Not that I saw it, of course. Oh, it was rather exciting.
No, I'll ring later.
There I was, stock taking in my shop, when in walked my friend Edie Chalk. You know, Edie Chalk from Halifax. And she showed me this cutting. She said, you'll hear something to your advantage if you contracted this Cooper out. Well, I really didn't. And you know, I was glad when I wanted. Oh, they were ever so nice to me. Gave me a lovely cup of tea. And Mr. Cooper, he explained everything to me. Mr. Cooper Senior, that was he. Oh, he was a lovely fella. He had beautiful silvery sideboards. Oh, he did suit the part ever so well. Now, where was I? Oh, yes, of course, I. Well, Mr. Cooper, you see, he said there was this letter awaiting the perusal at Barclays Bank, Pall Mall. Couldn't be opened by anybody but me. Well, quick as a flash, we was round there in the manager's office, up to our balls in tea again. And Mr. Cooper, he had a bit of a natter with the manager. And then in comes his chief clerk with a big deed box. It did make me feel ever so funny when he opened it. But inside, there was this envelope addressed to me. Mrs. B. Horrocks, nee Starling. Starling, you see, that was my father. Well, what it took to be my father. He was Lord Rothbury's butler. Anyway, do you know what was inside when he opened it?
No.
Well, I'll tell you. There was a codicil. A codicil to the will. I don't suppose you know what a codicil is, do you? So I'll tell you. A codicil is an adhesive to the will. And also inside, there was this letter. Addressed to me by Lord Rothbury, me own illegitimate father.
Breakfast is ready, sir. The you are Master Jeremy. We'll just put it there.
Here, Ram. What time do the workers clock on?
Clock on?
You know, start workers.
Already, they are in the fields. Work begins for them at daybreak.
Daybreak?
Yes, you see, they cannot work when the sun is getting too hot.
I see. I was forgetting about that. Oh, well, in that case, I think it's only fair if we all kick off at dawn.
Do you?
Oh, I do, Martin. If I'm taking over here, I want to be sure that the family is setting a good example. I know them. I have them. Who keeps an eye on them?
I do.
Well, you can't do that if you're snoring and sleeping bed, now can you? They might be fiddling the estate left, right and centre. Good morning, wee willy winky.
Morning, Beanie, your love. Drop up the mood.
Bit early for lunch, isn't it?
Oh, you made you stress, Beatie.
You're taking black, I suppose.
Yes, that's right.
I was just telling your big brother, there's going to be some changes round here.
Oh, yes, how's that? Well, we're all getting up at dawn for one thing. Good God.
No, I think it's only fair. If I'm taking over here, I think you've been a bit lackadaisical with your staff. I can just imagine what they're up to out there with the tie and the tips. I can hear them now. It'd be one leaf for Lady Eppingham, two leaves for me. I've had girls put two and mess in their mouths, but I still haven't stopped them walking out at 5:30 with 2 dozen reams of cotton stuffed up their knickers.
I think they'll be a little bit conspicuous walking over that sack of tea if they're dirty.
What's a dirty?
This is worn by Indian men. It is a long piece of material with ornamented borders. It is tucked in at the waist, after passing round the loins and between the legs.
Well, I think you're perhaps you're right. Doesn't sound the sort of place to stuff a sack of tea.
No.
There are other ways and means.
You don't do the best thing about the organization of a tea estate.
Granted, Martin, I don't, but I can learn. There's not much difference between tea and drapery. It's all business, profit and loss. Do you know, in the end, my accountant was coming to me for advice. I think that's why my dad, Lord Rothbury, denominated me for the job. He said so in that letter. He wasn't happy about the way that business was dropping off you. No offence meant, and none taken, I hope. But if there are any inefficiencies, I hope I'll be able to put my finger on them. Right? Come here. I want you to escort me around the estate. I want to have a natter with the pens.
charming turn up of the books, isn't she?
Blasted woman!
Not your type.
She's catching the first train out of there.
What I gather, she intends to stay. I think she'll be company for Auntie.
Since when have you been concerned for the old girl's welfare?
Oh, as from now, I'm going to be the model, then you. Hand it to her every whim. After all, you don't want to give her any reason to change the world before Caroline gets her, do we?
If he ever does.
Well, if he doesn't, I'm going to have to make those arrangements on my own.
If you interfere with this, I won't.
You pay people to do that for you, like Caroline. I suppose he's bringing it from the station.
Yes, when he arrives. God, I can't wait for this to be over. Then with Auntie out of the way, I get Carl to return and sell her for 100,000.
Do you know, I reckon if you pay your car twice, you get 150,000 for this place.
Ha!
By throwing in Mrs. Horrocks' lot number 13.
Good morning, gentlemen.
Oh, well, good morning, my dear. Oh, have you had your breakfast yet?
No, just black coffee. That's quite delicious.
You're not slimming, surely?
Yes.
Well, from what I can see, which is all too little, I'd say you had the perfect figure.
Thank you.
Tell me, Mrs. Virginia, do you go for that subtle, sophisticated approach?
A compliment is always most acceptable. I must say, you have a rather attractive home here.
You don't have to return the compliment.
I mean it. There's a great deal of charm.
Yes, the old world variety.
You should not despise the past, Mrs. Eppingham.
Well, I don't. I'd rather not live in a morgue, that's all.
Oh, don't worry. Mrs. Horrocks has a way. We'll have a neon sign over the gate and bingo every Friday.
Oh, yes. Mrs. Horrocks is quite a character. They are plain journey from Bombay, most enjoyable.
Oh, I'm sure she was the life and soul of the party.
Indeed, she was.
Stupid woman.
She may get the impression that she is naive, Mr. Eppingham, but my instinct tells me that she's a very shrewd lady.
Oh, is that so?
It is not unusual for it to cost the traveller to India a small fortune in quarter sticks.
You're not kidding.
However, I copied Mrs. Horrocks from Bombay to Calcutta and from there to Jaipur, and I found it a revelation in economics.
Typist, is she?
On the contrary, but a lack of knowledge of the currency caused such confusion with the quarters that she ended up with a handsome profit. It would be difficult to believe, if not for the striking facial resemblance, that Mrs. Horrocks and Lady Eppingham are sisters.
Half sisters, and even that remains to be proved.
Surely there is no doubt.
Well, I doubt it for one.
Come now, Mr. Eppingham. You would not doubt the veracity of my client.
Your turn, Martin.
Look, why didn't you go and get dressed? We don't want you lounging about like that.
Worry not. I'll be ready by the time Caroline gets you.
Caroline?
Yes.
Dr. Caroline?
Yes, why?
Oh, is he a family friend?
Hardly.
It's just a professional visit. He has this delightful nursing home up in the hills. Very exclusive.
And expensive.
Can't be the same one.
Oh?
A Dr. Caroline figured in one of my early court cases. From what I remember, he was a most unsavory character.
Oh, he can't be the same one. This one could do a nephew, isn't that right, Martin?
Go on, get out of there!
Put it down there!
Morning, Auntie.
Have you seen my sandwiches? Oh, that damn fool Ramon must have packed them with my binoculars.
Good morning, Lady Eppingham.
Ah, Lady Abercrombie. Do join us for the races today.
Never down this early. You should be in your bedroom.
Not on the day of the races. We've got Shalimar running in the Calcutta Gold Plate. If your husband has an extra 100 to spare, she's a very safe each-way bet. He's still with us, I hope. Your husband?
We're not married.
Oh, too much of this living together. I don't believe it.
Now, come on back to bed. You were going to rest.
No, not on the day of the races. But now, Shalimar was sired by Golden Miller. Or was it the other way around?
But there are no races today, Aunt.
No races?
No.
Have they been cancelled?
Yes, Aunt, cancelled.
It's all that snow, old glove.
Oh, don't talk rubbish, Jeremy. It's a beautiful sunny day. I worry about them sometimes, you know.
Now, come on.
No, no, no. I'm going to show Lady Abercrombie my hat.
She doesn't want to see it.
Of course she does. You do, don't you?
Oh, yes, please, very much.
Oh, there you are, clever lot. I find it very difficult to get really angry with them, knowing their background, no parent. And my husband is worse than no use because he's so seldom here. It's my belief that Harry has a love lust in Darjeeling, the deceitful wretch.
Uncle wouldn't have anything like that.
Anything like what?
A love lust in Darjeeling.
I should hope not. I could have been dead for years, but I just don't know how to tell them.
Oh, now, come on.
No. I'm going to show Lady Abercrombie my hat. I mean, it's for the races, and we don't want a clash, do we? There. I trust it's not too similar.
No.
Jerry?
Oh, lovely, Aunt.
Martin?
Oh, very nice.
Oh, and Lady Abercrombie?
Absolutely charming.
Oh, thank you. I think it's bloody awful.
Children of our own, have we?
Cecilia. Where is the document?
I haven't the faintest idea.
Well, if you could find it before lunch...
Anything's possible.
Morning, Lander, Sligwa. As well as I ever do in a strange bed.
Ah! Are you who'd spend the night without him?
Been a naughty boy, have you?
No worse than you. Let me see your hands.
Perfectly clean, Auntie.
Yes, well, they wouldn't be if you weren't, Carter. Come along, Mr. Landauer. We go time for an introduction to you before lunch.
I don't shoot.
Oh, but you shoot? Mm-hmm. I know to teach you.
Isn't there something else we should be doing?
What? Oh, well, if that's how you feel, to help Dr.
Hello? Did you hear that?
Yes, and a lot more.
You know, I think we might be in line for a new uncle as well.
We're in line for nothing. She's changing the will.
Well, good old contestant.
Not Rothbury's her own. She's leaving the lot to Mrs. Horrocks.
Poor Aunt Hester. She's only got herself to blame, is she?
If only Caroline could have got here.
If. There's no one here to help you now except me and a friend of mine.
Friend? What friend?
Just a friend.
Jeremy?
Mercy, sir! Sir! What is it? It is most disturbing, sir. It is Mrs. Horrocks.
What about her?
Well, she is engaged herself in conversation with some of the workers. Already she has offered them 100% increase in their wages.
My God. I'll deal with her later. Jeremy!
Ramon, I think you would find that Mrs. Horrocks is a most individual approach to economics.
She will have them all constructed if she's not being careful.
Mr. Eppingham will fire any troublemakers. That soon brings the others in line.
That is what they told themselves Horrocks they were afraid of.
Ah.
Then she told them to try the collective bargaining.
Come on, dear. Come along in. Don't be shy. Come along in, your China.
China?
Do you know what this little lad's been telling me? He hasn't had a day off in months.
There is very damn good reason for that.
What is that?
He is not entitled to work. And if I catch you talking to himself again, you won't get a deal at all.
Ramon, that's no way to treat people.
Oh,
I'm
not your
way to retire. If that little lad had been working at our jobs, you would have had the tickets at the gate for now.
They will be plentiful here.
That's no reason to take advantage of the situation. They were telling me about the contracts.
Contracts?
For them little tea pluckers.
Well, they haven't got any contracts.
That's what I mean. You're going to get them drawn up straight away, and we can hand them out first thing in the morning.
It's a pity you didn't arrive 200 years ago.
I would have been busy. No one's such a nationalist. And a social club. And you're not sure about it.
We are not having social clubs.
Well, where to play your bingo when you're down.
They do not go in for those part-time chairs.
What? No middle for dinner and legs 11?
We are not having 11 eggs.
Right. Well, convert one of them outside warehouses, and we'll have a special treat on Saturday, all time dancing. And then, of course, there's the annual outing to the seaside.
The nearest seaside is 400 miles away.
Well, why don't we take them up them hills there, then?
The people here?
Aye, they And anyway, you must have loads of those in beauty spots. Take them up the Cardiff Pass.
I'm rather sorry, I won't be here to see the results of her efforts.
I only hope Mlle Horrocks is still here.
I don't understand.
If she stays, she'll be in danger.
Mrs. Horrocks can take care of herself, Ramon.
Grave danger. I have seen a sign in the sky. It means an evil spirit in Jerry Pool. It comes with a stranger.
Dr. Caroline?
Caroline?
Oh, it's all right, Ramon. The doctor's not calling to see Mrs. Horrocks. And in any case, I believe she'd be more than a match for him.
No, it's not Dr. Caroline. No. The stranger has already arrived. It is Landau's son. He is the evil spirit.
Be quiet, Ramon.
I tell you, since he has arrived, there has been discord in this house. He is the evil one.
Ramon, for your own sake, be quiet.
He is the one.
Mr. Landau is not the only stranger to arrive here.
Who else?
Myself.
Are you a stranger, Mr. Pitya?
Stop fussing with that thing. Hurry up with my vanity doctor. What's that you've got there? Oh, give them to me.
I am quite sure you weren't injured at all.
I don't think so. But when you get to my age, you can't tell the difference between... between lumbago and buckshot. Did she look at the wind of my sister? What did she say she was going to do in the fields?
All night the lenses.
Oh, are they playing cricket?
It's a modern colloquialism. Would you care to drink this?
You try and stop me. This is the stuff to give the truths, Lady Abercrombie. Don't take the bottle, Doctor. Leave it there. And get rid of this thing. I don't think I shall shoot again today.
Very wise.
I had no idea it was loaded. What did I bring down?
A very little, apart from the stealing.
Oh, it's got a kick like a mule. Why didn't you dare to catch me, Harry?
Don't you think we should forget the shooting incident now?
Oh, but I have. I've forgotten all about it. It happened so many years ago. Where are you going to make an honest woman of Lady Abercrombie?
Well, I can call her Lady until after I've been mended in your will.
Oh, it's very good of you to put it off on my account.
Don't you think we should be looking for the document?
What a good idea. You have a look over there while I have a little rest before my journey. It's got to be around you, you see, Lady Abercrombie, because I don't think I lived anywhere else. Why don't you have a look in the work basket?
Certainly. What for?
My ring, of course. Now, where's it got to? Ah, there you are, Doctor. If you see Mr. Landau, tell him to come to my room.
I shan't be sorry when this visit's over.
No, Doctor.
I don't know what to do, I really don't.
Why are you looking for it?
Because Lady Eppingham wishes to amend it.
Really?
She's going to leave everything to Mrs. Horrocks instead of the two brothers. But if she doesn't know where it is, I really don't think we can be expected to, whatever happens, Miss Lupita, we are catching our train. I've waited nearly 3 days away from the office as it is.
Perhaps you should fly back.
Oh, no, thank you.
I think the quickest and simplest step would be to draw the fresh one.
Oh, I should have serious qualms about that. The opening line, I, Lady Cat, Lady Eppingham, being of sound mind.
What is Sav doing?
What do you want?
Has Sav lost something?
Don't you usually knock before you enter a room?
I just don't think there is anyone here. Perhaps I can help.
No,
It's all right, Tom. Just a letter belonging to Lady Eppingham.
Her Alicia's correspondence is kept in the office. Shall I
go? No. Getting down closer. Haven't they got any fans here?
No, sir.
I think we could do with some ice water. Oh, sweaty all day, Mr. Landau.
Oh, indeed it is, sir.
Oh, we'll have to find the answer for this little lot.
Quite.
I'll
get you some ice water.
Oh, no, I don't fancy that down in front of me. I fancy something stronger. Have you got any ties, then?
Ties,
sir? Yes, you know, ties, sir.
No, we have Coca-Cola.
But mix that with some orange and a squirt of soda and we'll have our own. You'd like some, wouldn't you, dear?
No, thank you.
Aren't you hot?
Not particularly.
Well, I suppose that wearing that safari helps. And you have been boiling in that soup.
No.
Have you got a vest on?
No.
That explains it, you see. You're cheating. I'm still dressed for the English winter. Do you know, when I left Halifax, there were 18 inches of icicles hanging on my overflow. They won't ask me a job when that clock goes, I can tell you. Man, not that I should worry. I sold it to some Pakistanis. Oh, I hope you have to.
No, it is no more than they deserve.
Eh? I was forgetting. You lot don't hit it off together, do you? Colour problem, is it?
I will get a drink. Coca bloody cola.
Was it something I said?
Oh, nothing, Mrs. Horrocks, nothing.
It is a religious problem, Mrs. Horrocks. Very complex.
Oh. The Pakistanis are Muslims.
Oh, not TV like you would be, eh?
Really?
As it happens, I'm a Hindu. No, you're never. Well, I've no time for prejudice. I think all those who won't live and let live ought to be shot.
Oh, yes, that's the word.
I mean, that isn't long enough, is it?
No, we're none of us perfect.
I mean, here's me illegitimate, and her Indian, but we don't let that get us down, do we?
Tell you the truth, Mrs. Horrocks, my nationality has never embarrassed me.
No, that's quite right. You've got to rise above that sort of thing. I mean, most people have come in our garden.
look at you, we've got that little bit extra in life. Do you know, up until 3 days ago, every day was the same for me. I was just one of the humdrum millions. But now I get up in the morning and I say, Beatty, you're unique. You're illegitimate.
Yes,
oh, it's more of a bonus in my case, because I was sired by a nobleman, see?
Yes, that must have been a great surprise to him.
Well, of course, and it wasn't if you get the meaning. Even as a little girl, it wouldn't have surprised me if you'd grown up to be a princess. But you see, I was brought up among the knobs, you see. It was one stately home after another up until I was 13, but with one moment I'd been in service. Well, I say that, but I didn't know the rights of the matter then. I suppose you could say, me dad was noble enough to step in and put the bill after Lord Rothbury put up the account. After me, in front of the nerves.
Your ties are mixed up. Shall I put it down there?
No, I think we'll have it out on the balcony. It doesn't seem quite dark now.
I don't think that is advisable, Mr. Sir. The rains are coming.
Oh, Lord, I thought it was clouded over.
Oh, go on, take it through. A nice little shower will freshen everything up. Go on, take it through.
Sometimes our little showers can last as long as 6 weeks.
How long?
There's havoc with the trains. If it gets really bad, it can wash the traps away.
Oh, I can't believe that. Anyway, you should worry. Take an aeroplane.
In a raging storm?
Well, they fly over it.
Well, they have to get through it first.
Oh, I see. You've got a bit of a funny tummy, have you?
Well, yes.
Well, you don't need to worry, you see, because they keep you well supplied with them little paper bags. And then all you have to...
Yes, yes, thank
you. Mr. Landau, why don't you telephone the railway station at Gerald Court? They'll probably put your mind at ease.
Oh, I can just imagine what they'd say if you rung up King's Cross and said, looks like rain this morning. Got any line left between you and King's
Cross? What I was saying, I think I was just checking the station and see what they'd say. May I use your telephone, Mrs. Holland?
Yes, you may. Go on. I tell you what, if it really comes on to rain, we can all sit round and watch the television.
There's no television in Gen 4.
No television? Not even BBC?
Not even the
aircraft
transmitter.
Hello? Hello?
There are no more transmitting stations.
Well, I think they'd be able to bounce it off one of them, what do they call them, stalagmites up there.
Hello? Hello?
Oh, it's your lady friend.
The phone's dead.
Are you sure?
Well, it's dead now,
Miss Up.
Oh, sir.
Did you know the confounded telephone was out of order?
No, sir.
Oh, here. Oh, it's been tired, sir. Come with this look, look. Come on. Can you hear me? No, you're quite right. It's dead.
This often happens in the rainy season.
You mean the wires down?
Oh, I should never have sent that taxi away last night. I should have gone when I intended. I would have if you want to ride.
Oh, did you stay on my account? How nice. Come on, everybody. Out onto the veranda. I've never seen a tropical monsoon before.
Ramua, is there another telephone in the house?
Yes, sir. There's an extension on the upstairs landing.
Upstairs? Well, I think it might be advisable if I check the number. Now, I'll be back in a moment.
Is it me and old fidgety Richard? I say, is it that Mr. Landau married?
I don't know. I only joined the firm recently.
I hope not. I wouldn't mind taking him on. I enjoy a challenge. Come on, let's take us alone, lad. You sit there, and we'll keep this seat for Mr. Landau. Oh, you've got a lovely view of the inn here. And you haven't touched your drink.
Yes, I've had a sip, thank you.
Don't you like it?
I think we have to acquire a taste for him, or else he's very thirsty.
Oh, well, I'm thirsty, all right. Oh, I say, where's the trench this up from? The catches. Way up and started. Hello, gentlemen.
Hello, Beatty.
Come to one of the fireworks?
Yes, won't be long now either.
Exciting, isn't it?
Yes, I suppose your first one is.
Better than Blackwood Illuminations.
Looking for anything?
I'm looking for that damn will.
Oh, don't bother.
It's not in the office, it must be in her room. If only Caroline could have got it today, she'd have been carted off by now.
He didn't, and she hasn't. Martin, I've got a present for her.
Well, see,
I hope she'd rather have it.
What is it?
Well, it's a little party gift for Aunt Esther. I know you'll agree. I picked it up just now.
You bloody fool! You know I can't stand those things!
I know, so
and neither can Aunt Esther. One bit more friend in there, and she'll be saying, "Oh, Daddy, here I come."
"You're mad."
"That helicopter has a regulator." "Well, the sooner we are, why don't I have my own business, Mr. Pitcher, the sooner I can go."
"You're always wanting to go. There's nothing wrong with you, is there? Come on, I'll leave it there, and wrap your guns around that, we cool you off."
"Peculiar colour, isn't it?"
"Excuse me, sir. Lady Eppingham wishes to see you."
"What about?"
"She did not tell me, sir."
"Oh, very well.
Also, sir, she thinks she is leaving her hat box down here."
"Oh, so good." "There.
Very good, sir." "Ramon, don't bother. As Martin's going upstairs, he'll take you with him, won't you, Martin?"
"Very good, sir. She said she would like it as soon as possible, sir."
"Don't worry. She'll get it." Along came a spider and sat down beside her. "Come on, Martin." Faith, it's up to you.
You don't think I'd be such a bloody fool as to try that again, do you?
No, I don't mean I'm bending here. testify against her husband.
Testify to what?
Our investment. Our new owner has shown us how inquisitive she can be. So when she patronizes the account books, she'll have a few questions to ask, I can tell you.
To read anything into those account books, you'd have to be a chartered accountant.
I have a sneaking suspicion that's what she is. Anyway, it's about time we got her settling down. It's better than 5 years of investment.
You think so?
Excuse me, sir.
How long have you been up there?
Just a moment, sir. The rains have started.
You don't know what's happened, do you?
No, sir.
Would you mind if I'd gone upstairs and given Miss Lupetti a hand?
Well, isn't Land out there?
Oh, yes. And he took one foot into the body and he had to stick his head between his knees.
Okay, don't do anything till I come down.
What is it? What has happened?
Prepare yourself for a bit of a shock, Drew. It's my poor sister. She's been murdered. And I found this scarf round her neck.
Oh!
Oh, my God!
Miss Lucina, Mama! How could Krishna be so cruel?
There's no problem.
Oh. She was the greatest, kindest lady in the world.
Yes, yes, but you've got to realise, you see, that she wasn't a young lady. She'd had a good innings. You see, she didn't have a crown put off.
And now she has gone to her death.
Ah, well, that's life.
I will be done also.
Now that's enough of that sort of talk. We don't want us all going to pieces. You've got to remember, it's always darkness before dawn.
My God, it's angry!
Is he?
It does not bode well for the killer of my mistress.
Well, I'm glad to hear it.
She shall have a funeral, fit for a queen.
Of course she shall.
She shall float down the Ganges on a burning pyre.
Well, it sounds a bit ostentatious, but we'll have to see what the insurance money will run to. Say, when will the funeral be? I haven't got a thing to wear.
Tomorrow.
So soon?
Certainly.
Oh, I was forgetting. I don't suppose you can keep them hanging around down in the seat, can you? The trouble is, you see, it's not the sort of thing you think of, is it? I mean, I only found her 2 days ago. I didn't expect to lose her so soon.
Oh!
For God's sake, get a grip on yourself. Oh, how are you feeling now, Mr. Landau?
Oh, Ramo, get me a drink, will you?
Yes, sir. Whiskey, gin,
or anything.
Make it a brandy and make it too.
No, ma'am, sir. It is against my religion.
Well, it's not for you, you damn bastard, for me.
Well, I had a presentiment of disaster as soon as I entered this house.
Oh, you'll get on well with Edie Chalk.
Who?
Edie Chalk, my friend from Halifax.
Oh, yes, sir.
She gets funny feelings all the time.
Dreadful business, dreadful.
Oh, well, I grant you.
I should never have come.
Well, what about me? Well, you've only come down the road. I've come 18,000 miles. I've only been here 5 minutes and I'm your sister. Stiff as a poker and I'm all hold up.
Yes, yes.
You're branding yourself. So,
thank you.
Oh, I'll never forget those eyes as long as I live. They were like 2 poached eggs.
Oh, this is horrible.
Oh, I say, you still feeling a bit queasy? Oh.
Has anyone been off to the police yet?
No, not so far. There hasn't been time.
Well, there's absolutely nothing we can do until they arrive. Ramu, see that none of the houseboys leave the premises.
Well, you're wasting your time with that thing, aren't you?
There was always a chance that it was only temporary.
Here, wait a minute.
Do what you're told, Ramu. See that none of the staff leave the premises.
If some would permit me to say,
I object to what you're told.
This cannot be done by Hindus.
I am not interested in your theories, Ramu.
It is someone living in this house.
I see. We've been cut off.
That's been severed.
You don't say.
I mean on fingers. With a sharp instrument.
With a knife. With a scissors.
A scissor or knife? Why can't be sure?
No. If it had been a knife, it would only been squeezed in on one side. But if you look, it's been squeezed in on both. That's a scissors, that is.
Are you some sort of detective?
No, Mr. Draper. There's not much you can teach me about scissors.
Mimsar's being very observant.
Who would want to do a thing like that?
Same persons would want to do a thing like that.
Ramo, we must get hold of the police in Janakpur. Where's the nearest telephone?
In Janakpur.
Well, where's the nearest neighbour?
Beyond Janakpur.
Well, one of us will have to drive into the village. Do you have a vehicle of some kind?
Martinsar has a Land Rover.
Right, I'll take that.
Bring her round to the front, will you?
Yes, sir.
Ramua, how far is it to Jamnapur?
Well, it is 6 miles at the bridge, then another 3 miles. A little over 20 miles, sir.
Bit quick off the mark, where won't you?
My dear good woman, someone has to go.
Yes, but why you? Why not one of the servants?
Because they are totally unreliable. Once they get clear, they may never come back.
Well, the same thing applies to you, doesn't it?
You're being ridiculous. How could I be involved in such a hideous affair? I've never met Lady Eppingham until yesterday.
Oh, we've only got your word for that.
But I don't start to gain anything whatsoever. I'm in the sympathetic party, and I ask you, do I look like a murderer?
Did Jack the Ripper?
According to you, if we follow your train of thought to its logical conclusion, Mrs. Hollis, then anyone in this house is a potential suspect.
That's it. 10 out of 10.
But on the face of it, there's only one person who has actually gained anything from Lady Eppingham's death.
Who's that?
Yourself.
What a dreadful thing to say. Do I look like a murderer?
You're Jack the Ripper.
Well, in that case, short of a carrier pigeon, we're all going to be stuck here forever, is that it?
Well, there's any number of us who could go.
Who?
Well, either of your two nephews.
Oh, Mr. Fitzgerald?
No, I think not.
I beg your pardon.
Oh, I'm sorry, I didn't realise you were there.
Have you recovered, Mr. Landau?
It was only a momentary thing, the heat.
Ah, and then staring eyeballs didn't help much either.
Have you been able to contact the police yet?
Not so far, no.
But it's imperative, they must come at once.
Exactly what I keep trying to tell Mrs. Horrocks.
Well, I'm not arguing with you about that. It's just a case of deciding who's the best person to go.
Does it matter?
Well, of course it does. You don't want to send him what does it, do you?
Or her?
Hey, you're a right-handy woman, you are. I lay you 6 to 4, he's not married.
I am bringing the car around the front, sir. But please be driving carefully. The rain has washed the surface away.
Right, I'll be as quick as I can.
Hold your horses, Mr. Lackhouse.
Now look here, Mrs. Holland.
Let's go.
What?
If I'm in charge here, which I am, you will go as you go, which you will. If you insist on going, you're not going on your own.
You'll accompany me, will you?
Oh, no, I'm staying here to keep an eye on things. He'll go with you. All right with you, Lou.
Very good, Mr.
I think it's really my duty to stay here.
I shall go alone.
No.
Sergeant don't want me to go?
No, I consider it unwise.
Why does Sergeant want the police here?
How dare you?
I'm all right. You won't be ashamed of yourselves. What with you pester still lukewarm upstairs? Perhaps does anyone be objective, Mr. Pitya goes. And it's all the same if you do. You don't mind going, do you, dear?
No, if it is your wish. Now I think it's a bit of collaboration.
This way, Mr. Pitya.
And don't forget to tell them everything you know when you get there.
Of course, everything.
Down the telephone. Makes everything twice as difficult.
Well, I suppose that was the idea.
I mean, it's no concern of mine, of course, but there's a post-mortem to arrange the funeral.
Post-mortem? But that would delay the funeral, won't it?
Certainly.
Yes, but they go to float it down the Ganges on a burning tyre.
It's a murder, Mrs. Horrocks.
It sounds a bit undignified to me, even. Well, you know, I was telling Ramua I didn't have anything to wear for the funeral. Well, I suppose it would be a bit different if I was to wear my sister's hat. I mean, it fits the bill, doesn't it? Something borrowed, something blue. I'm not averse to a bit of ritual. Eh, I'd rather go for this. How does it look? I say, does it look all right? What's the matter with you? You've got a very funny colour. You're stuck up playing you up again.
Now I'm going to have to do something that may seem a bit unusual, but whatever happens, just move and don't cry out.
Oh my God!
Stay quite still.
It's been worked on it. You're out of bed.
This is no good.
Why pick on me?
Not you, it's your hat.
Well, anyway.
should have a brandy.
With or without soda?
Without.
How will you feel it now, Mrs. Horrocks?
Oh, Mr. Lander, can you ever forgive me? It's just the way you were looking at me. I thought I was a goner.
Yes, yes, I dare say.
Now, of course, I can see how very brave you were.
Oh, well, one does have to rise to these things when the occasion demands.
His office back.
Well, I don't usually start this early, but we'll call it medicinal. Ta, I'll have the other half now. I suppose in time you get used to all these creepy crawlies out here, do you?
I can't honestly say that I have.
No, Martin.
Oh, dear. I don't suppose there's been any mistake, has there? My sister didn't want me to have this place, did she?
No doubt whatsoever.
Well, in that case, I suppose I'll just have to get busy with the flit gun. Oh, what you with a merry widow. As a matter of fact, I was going out with the account books this afternoon. I suppose you use a lot of electrical peeping, will you?
Oh, well, to tell you the truth, they're in a bit of a mess at the moment. I tell you what, let me have them for a couple of days and I'll get them into some sort of order.
No, trouble yourself. I'll be able to sort them, all right.
I think we ought to take some statements from the start before the police gets here.
Good idea.
That's all right. Me and Mr. Lander can do it. Can't we, Mr. Lander?
Will Mrs. Horrocks be all right down here with your brother?
Why shouldn't she be?
Oh, yes. A lot of girls around will give a lot for that.
Oh, I see. Bit of a lady killer, is he?
Yes. Come on.
Hey, Martin. I hope you didn't take the last remark too literally about you being a lady killer, are you?
This sort of thing is bound to make us all feel a bit edgy.
Oh, I don't think I'm going to have another. I'll be tiddly poos.
I'm going to have one.
I suppose you're feeling the strain of it too, aren't you, dear?
Oh, no, not particularly.
Well, I don't suppose I'll be able to wear this now. I'll just have to hold it. As the dog said when he was halfway across the Sahara.
You know, Pity, there's more to you than meets the eye.
Well, as my George used to say, once round you, Petey, twice round the next works. Well, I do rather tend to run towards fact. Well, it's not so much of a run, really. It's more of a headlong dash.
Oh, I wouldn't give you tuppence for a skinny woman.
They're all the go now, you know. Topless, bottomless, and homeless.
Oh, no, not my type, I assure you.
Oh, go on.
No, when I settle down, it'll be with a mature woman.
Well, now I know your specifications. To see if I can find you a nice little wife.
Well, as a matter of fact, I think I've already found one.
Ooh, have you known alone?
No, not very.
That's the best way to start a marriage, I always think. No point starting out knowing you've made a mistake. Let it creep up on you from behind.
Yes, that's a point.
Have you any young lady named today yet?
Well, to tell you the truth, I haven't had the courage to ask her to marry me yet.
Don't run the hand around, Martin, otherwise somebody else might come and fall under a spell.
No, I don't think that's very likely.
Oh, what you like? That end of a bus?
More
homely.
Yes, that's the word.
You still don't want to let the grass grow under your feet. You want to take your courage in both hands and say, Beloved, will you marry me?
You're right, of course. Beloved, will you marry me?
That's it. But with a bit more feeling.
Oh, will you marry me?
That's better.
Well, will you...
Eh?
Marry me?
What?
What's your answer, BT?
I'll have another brandy. What? Me? At my age?
I told you I prefer my women matured.
Mature, yes. But not vintage.
Oh, please don't confuse me. My life out here has been a nightmare, and I can't say it hasn't left its mark on me, but I believe Providence has brought us together, and I will make you a good husband, I swear it. Now, what do you say?
Pull the other one. It's got bells on.
I don't think you understand.
I understand, all right. What are you up to?
What do you mean?
I may not have had a posh education, but I know a wrong one when I see one.
Then go back to where the hell you came from, you damned imperial old busybody.
That's much more like the charming Martin that we know.
Don't say I didn't warn you. If you don't get out of here while you've got the chance, you're going to end up as dead as your sister.
We'll see about that. over to you, and you can all keep an eye on each other. The less people you've got wandering round, the better. Go on, here we go.
Smells good, is it, Brass?
No, they're in the room, sir.
Is there any good for Mrs. Horrocks?
What?
You ain't in Vindaloo.
In the where?
Very hot indeed, very.
Oh, lovely.
Get us something milder.
I can eat curry with the best of them. It's you that needs cooling off. Use your chopsticks. We've got stacks of Indian restaurants in Halifax. There's more stars of India in Cleckheaton Road than you've had off dinners. Oh, Mr. Pitcher, how are you feeling?
A little better, thank you. Fortunately, I have very thick hair.
Oh, and a very pretty one. You shouldn't have come down so soon.
You want to watch him, love? He's on the rebound.
You're lucky to be alive.
She is in this house.
Mrs. Horrocks, I don't find that very amusing.
Neither do I.
How the hell are we...
What in that battle?
How the blazes are we to get a police here now that the impounded bridge is down?
Oh, don't worry, that's left to wait for the bridge back up again.
Mr. Pitcher.
No, I haven't had a chance to thank you yet for avoiding more serious accidents.
He drove you straight into a tree. What precisely did he avoid?
A 200-foot chasm.
We only have his word for that.
I tell you the bridge is broken.
All right, keep your turban on. And you, stop upsetting the servants.
I can assure you the reason we spurred up the road was to avoid certain death.
Whenever the rain's come, that bridge is the first to go.
Should turn that damn thing off.
Well, I'd rather like it.
I don't.
Oh, he's a real anti-Mary. Go on, Jeremy, turn it off. God help your wife if you ever get one.
I doubt if we'll never get anything ever again.
You'll tell me, sir.
You was wrong there, wasn't you?
Is the telephone still out of order?
It was cut.
Cut?
With the scissors. I spotted that. Nobody else but me.
What about it?
You'll find them scissors, you'll find the murderer.
Yes, yes, yes. But without the police meeting here, nothing can be solved.
Master Jim.
Here. Not so much of your masters. What about your mistress? Ha! Oh, that was a pulverized man, George. What's the matter with you all?
You'll forgive us if we can't share your levity.
Look, you've got to put a brave face on a situation like this. As I say, eat, drink and be merry, but tomorrow we'll be well. Have you got me grub there?
Yes, Ben, sir. But only a little bit of
oh, don't keep on. I tell you, I'm all right with this spicy food. I'm a devil for horseradish sauce, ketchup. Oh, and I'm a devil for the old top ends. Oh. I'll tell you what it tastes like. Lancashire hot pot with a jollof of marmite. Oh my God.
Has something struck you?
Oh my. Not off. Oh. Oh my God.
I think Mrs. Horrocks would like a glass of water.
Never mind the glass. I'll have the jug. Oh! If that's your idea of a joke, you can collect your cards.
Call up the same, Mrs. Horrocks.
I think I've been the overlay.
Have a banana.
I'm the same for you.
No, that's how to cool them out.
Oh, penis one round.
You ought to have stayed at home.
I am at home.
Your other one. The sooner you get out of the chip, the better.
You'd love that, wouldn't you, Sam? You'd like to keep me quiet one way or another.
Stupid.
Oh, so I'm stupid now, am I? Can you believe that this morning he wanted to marry me?
Good God, no.
No, neither did I. But when that little ruse failed, he tried to talk to me curry.
Oh, really? That's a dangerous accusation.
That's not the only thing he's been doctoring. Boy, you should see them account books. Harley Street surgeon couldn't have carved them up better. You just ask him how they managed to pick 400... ton of tea a year, and only 200 goes through the book.
That is a damn lie.
Be careful, Mrs. Horrocks.
No, it's in the door to be careful.
Just a minute, Beatty. Are you absolutely sure of your facts?
Positive. Big brother's on the fiddle.
Martin, I'm surprised at you. What the hell are you talking about? Oh, don't worry. I'm sure Beatty won't prefer charges. So what are they then, these ledgers?
Oh, never you mind.
Come on now, Beatty. If you can accuse Martin in front of all these witnesses, surely you can produce the proof.
I'll produce the proof when the police arrive, and not before. I don't think I trust anyone in this house anymore.
Hear that, Mr. Lander? Not even the laws above suspicion in this house.
As I've already pointed out, there is only one person who
has gained anything from Lady Eppingham's death, and that is Mrs. Horrocks.
Oh, when Daniel comes to judgment.
One doesn't have to be a lawyer to work that out.
And how do we know that you are?
How what?
Well, you say you're a solicitor. How do I know you're certified?
Well, maybe.
Things aren't always what they seem, you know. A cat can have kittens in the oven, but that doesn't make them biscuits. Oh, and who's going to vouch for you? Him, is it?
Certainly.
Oh, I see. She scratches your back and you scratch hers. Is that it?
There is only one person who can tell us who murdered Lady Eppingham.
Who's that?
Lady Eppingham.
Or a remove. He spends as much time in the next world as he does in this.
Each to his own belief, Mr. Eppingham.
It's worth a try, though.
What?
Calling up the dead.
Calling up a what?
You know, table tapping.
Rubbish. Come on, let's try. I'll clear the table.
Mumbo jumbo.
Well, can't the way down to Oscar.
Oscar what?
Who snuffed her out?
Well, I refuse to take part.
Why? Are you afraid your name will come floating down the chimney?
One game. How about you, Miss McNivia?
Yes.
Right. Answer for those in favour of calling up your sister. Right, I'll duck your ass out, did she?
Why, come on in, walk your chairs.
Well, if I must, I suppose I must.
Now, what can we do?
Don't you know?
No, not really.
I said it were rubbish. How about you, Mr. Pittier? Do you know the drum?
I have never practiced it, no.
Well, it can't be all that difficult. Edie Chalk only went a couple of times, and she's not that quick on the uptake. She was the one that tried to get me to get in touch with George after he went.
Why didn't you?
Well, we weren't on speaking terms at the time. I hope it works with all this storm around.
Why shouldn't it?
Well, I mean, it's just wafted around up there in the atmosphere. She don't want to get caught on a piece of fork lightning. Now, who is? Now, shall we use fingertips, cards, or moving glass?
What?
What method shall we use?
Well, it can't make any difference. You'll never reach her.
Why? What time is it? She can't be got very far. Yes. From what I hear about the way she can soak it up, she should give her the brandy glass a treat.
Maybe I'll be keen.
Well, assuming Lady Eppingham is prepared to visit her, sir, how precisely does she utilise the glass?
Right. Once she's inside, she shoots around the table, leaving us little messages. Well, at least that's what Edie Chalk says. She does it every Christmas round her house, all it's ever since. Not in the meal, of course. They have a bit of supper, then after supper they have a knees up, and then they call up the dead. Oh, it's ever so jolly.
Can't wait to be Edie.
Well, you'd like her. She's looking for her husband. Now, oh, I was forgetting the most important part. I was forgetting the pieces of paper.
Paper?
Yes, she got out letters round the table, like A, B, C.
Oh, the alphabet.
Yes. So how many shall we need?
Well, I should try 26.
Yes, and we need an extra two.
What are they for?
Well, they've got yes and no one. And I'll tell you for why. Because Edie Chalk explained it to me. She said these spirits get right fed up going round the table going Y-E-S and then N-O.
Why don't we just stick to yes and no? It won't confuse Aunt Hester.
Good idea. Oh, say, isn't it exciting, Jeremy? Has anybody got a pair of scissors?
I have.
Oh, have you?
Most women do.
I don't. Do you?
What?
They seem to be missing. Oh, let's have a look.
When did you last have them?
I can't be sure.
Well, they're not there now.
The sooner we get in touch with Aunt Hester, the better.
Well, we'll just have to tear the paper. Come on, Martin, and take a few.
Might as well be hanging for a sheep. What's next then, teacher?
Right. Well, once she's inside, we hold the fingers lightly on the glass and concentrate like hell.
Right. Yes and no.
Right. And for goodness sake, don't know what this means.
And who will be our spokesman?
Eh?
Well, some damn fool's going to ask the questions.
Well, that can be me, of course.
Oh, of course.
But have you got extra sensory perception?
Certainly not.
But surely you should find out first if you have some of your other powers.
All right. Does anybody here feel the physic? No? In that case, I'll have to ask the question then. Right, come on. Fingers on, everybody. God. Edith ought to really be here now. She's really quite good at this. Come on, and get up. Esther? Can you hear me, Esther? Ah, you can't expect her to come through all at once. Like the radio, she's got to warm up first. Esther? Can you hear me? We want you. We need your help, Esther. Grubs. You've arrived. Come in and speak.
Are you wanting your tea now?
No, we'll have it in a minute. Put him over there. We're trying to call up my sister.
No, no, you must not do that.
Oh, stop interfering.
I have seen a sign.
All right, the scene is the pipe out.
It means death.
Don't be so hysterical. Now go and stand over there and be quiet.
Come on, Madame.
I'm sure I'm right in saying the other world can only reach us through medium. Well, we haven't got them, so we'll just have to soldier on. Who did that?
Oh, I did. Aunt Esther did my quite lights.
Oh, no, Jeremy. It'll give us all the cobble wobbles.
Oh, look, if we like it. This thing, let's get on with it.
All right, come on. Fingers on, everybody. We'll have another go on. I said fingers on, Mr. Lander. It's not going to work if you don't cooperate. You go and get me something. I think he's dead. Oh, no. Who's doing that?
Stop the curry.
Crumbs, we must have sent him off.
Beijing.
Shh. Don't nobody move.
Beijing.
Esther, is that you?
No. George Horrocks.
What the bloody hell are you doing here?
I heard you calling.
Since when has your name been Esther?
Sandy, you're all right, BG.
Of course I'm all right, now get off the bloody line. I'm going to ask him. We want to speak to Lady Eppingham. Esther, can you hear me?
Oh, must not be a power cable.
I am not liking the dark!
The generator! I'm going to switch over to the generator!
Come straight back! And the rest of you keep stock still. I'm not having it with Mrs. Knuckles.
I have seen a sign. It means death for somebody.
Ah, you if you're not bloody careful. I'm
sorry, Mrs. Horrocks. I was looking for my handbag.
Well, don't do it again. Oh, well done, Martin.
Oh.
Oh, here we go again.
Sister.
Sir, is that you?
Sister.
Yes?
Hear me.
We are listening to you. Go on. Oh, I think she's very faint. I expect her throat's still bothering her.
Listen to me. Listen.
We are listening, dear.
I was murdered.
Vishnu Shiva Brahma!
Will you shut up?
Murdered.
Did you see who the murderer was?
He.
So it was a man.
Wait. Ring.
Oh, like an engagement ring.
Ah.
I think she's going from us. Oh, don't go, dear. You only just arrived.
Ah.
Well, that's not the curry.
Is he all
right? That's all.
Martin, sir.
Hey?
Martin, sir, where's the ring?
What?
The ring, she said about the ring.
Martin's not the only one who wears a ring.
Well, he is in this house.
We can't be Martin.
Well, he hasn't come back, has he?
I said it can't be.
He is the killer.
It's a lie. It's a lie. We're going to do it with a spider. But we didn't have the chance. That's the truth. I mean, he must be. Martin? Martin!
Well, we must follow him quickly. Make sure they don't do anything foolish.
Who from?
Ramu's sister. She and Sir Harry. It was Ramu. Ramu killed me.
Oh, Mr. Lander, darling man. Jeremy! Jeremy!
I'm sorry.
Because he found out that I murdered her husband.
You mean it was you that killed her, Harry?
Yes. Because the native girl he shamed was my sister. The murder put... his death put himself so much out of my mind, I was able to persuade her that she had murdered him.
What a dreadful thing to do.
Memsahib was always most grateful that I did not betray her secret. And you, Memsahib, will not betray mine.
No! No!
Got FA at Oxford.
Oh, thank you.